we say goodbye to Barnsley and hello to Birmingham City. So we are now the manager of Birmingham City. It did take me quite a while to find a new club. As you can see, it is now the 26th of September in the new season. And unfortunately for us, there's already been 16 games played. The transfer window has gone. But unfortunately, no championship jobs really opened up at the back end of last season. And we had to wait until people started getting sacked during the new season for our opportunities to open up. Now, there was a good few championship clubs who did sack their manager quite early in the season. As you can see, Sheffield United and Millwall, we have already applied previous to actually getting the interview at Birmingham. And Reading has just become available not too long ago as well. So we do have applications in with other clubs. I don't know if I can actually withdraw that. I don't think I can. So that'll just play out its course. And obviously we won't be joining them clubs now that we have joined Birmingham. So their situation isn't exactly that fantastic. As you can see, their run of form in the championship hasn't been great since the start of the season. Only picking up, what's that, maybe 5 wins in the league, which led to them sitting currently in 19th position. Only 4 wins in the league season, sorry, in 16 games, 9 defeats, 3 draws. They're not doing fantastically, but they do have a better squad than Barnsley did when we first took over. And on Barnsley, by the way, if you stick around, I will be looking at their transfers and how they are going on a couple of months into the season. So if you take a look at our squad depth and in terms of what you're looking at in terms of major players for Birmingham City, the main one is, of course, Jude Bellingham. He is still at the club. He hasn't been poached by one of the big boys yet, which is absolutely fantastic news for us because it means we've either got a player who will sail through to the Premier League within a season or two, or we can sell for absolutely huge money and be able to reinvest that into the squad. He is one of the main players who we will look to build a side around. We've got the likes of Ivan Sunjic. He is a very, very talented 25-year-old Croatian midfielder. He's more than good enough for the Championship, probably good enough for the Premier League as well. He's one of our key players alongside Jude Bellingham. We do have a couple of good, really, really good young players as well. Keith Lonsdale is a regen who's currently the number one right back at the club at 18 years old. And as you can see, he's already pretty well rounded, good enough for the Championship. He's played 15 games for them already this season, and he will be my number one going into the rest of this season. We've got a couple of key areas though, which is pretty poor. First of which is right back. Ryan Burke, rated as our best right back. Now, he does have some good potential, but at 21 years old and only at 2.5 stars, it's probably unlikely he's going to be one of our major players. So further down the line, it will be an area I will have to address at some point should we be able to get some transfer funds. And goalkeeper is another one. We have a very, very poor goalkeeping setup. As you can see, 3 2-star goalkeepers. And the one who's going to be playing is 18 years old, and he's English. Now, 18 years old, he looks absolutely fantastic. It's just unfortunate for us that he is actually our best goalkeeper. So, I don't know. We'll play him, obviously, because we've got no other option. And we'll see where we stand in the January, whether we need to look to invest there, if we've even got the opportunity to do so. And the reason why I say that is because we have a £0 transfer budget, only £330 in the wages. And we're already spending 326 as well. So there's only £3,000 available for us to be able to play with. So it's unlikely Birmingham are going to be able to make massive moves this season unless we sell. 75% of transfer revenue is currently being made available, but we are losing money every single month. So I wouldn't be surprised if that ended up changing towards the January transfer window. In terms of what the board and things expect of us, we have took over and said we will get Birmingham City into the mid-table, which I'm pretty confident of being able to do. They have a good squad, probably capable of challenging for the playoffs if we had started at the beginning of the season rather than basically halfway through. The cup competition's not important, but they are expecting us to work towards getting promotion to the Premier League at the start of next season and then winning promotion in the Premier League within 3 years. So there's the gauntlet set. We've got this season mid-table, next season challenging, season after we've got to be promoted to match our board's expectations. Now, I know this tactic looks familiar, very familiar. It looks like Barnsley's tactic. And I came into this job with a full expectation that I would want to change formation just to freshen things up in terms of the save. But as it turns out, Birmingham's squad is ideal for this formation. I know it works. I know it's effective. So I'm not changing it. This would be my ideal first 11 should everybody be fit and everything work how it should. As we've already mentioned, Rhea Boyd will be our goalkeeper, 18 years old. We'll look to address that in the January if possible. Keith Lonsdale, again, our young 18-year-old right back. He will be our starting right back for the rest of this season. Harley Dean, 31 years old now, a decent championship centre-half. Not somebody who I would want to play in the Premier League, but for this season at the very least and maybe next, he will be a very, very capable centre-half for us, I have no doubt. And alongside him, we have Philippe Sandler, a 25-year-old Dutchman. Got a little bit of potential to grow, potentially. Potential. Physically, he's very well-rounded. Mentally, aggression. I hate the fact that it's seven, but something we're going to have to deal with. He is just a pretty well-rounded centre-half for this level, so I think he'd be more than good enough to be able to challenge for promotion at one time or another. Ryan Burke, again, as I've already said, is an area which I will have to improve at some point, but for now, he's going to have to do. Sonjic will play in that deep-lying playmaker role. Now, he doesn't really know that role very well, but he has got the attributes to absolutely smash it, so he is being trained to become more competent in that player role. Jude Bellingham will find himself playing in the centre of midfield in the Metzala role for us. Box-to-box is what we usually play, but given his attack and talent, I really wanted to take advantage of that, and he is naturally gifted in the Metzala role. I would like, if I had £20 million to spend right now, I wouldn't mind signing just a workhorse in here and moving Jude Bellingham up into the attack midfield position, but for now, he will be playing in the centre of midfield. On the right-hand side, we have Jeremy Bella. He will be playing as a winger on the right-hand side, which is a departure from what we used to do at Barnsley. But he is our best player on that side, and I would like somebody to be able to supply our striker as much as possible. 29 years old now, worth £9.5 million. A lot of these players could find themselves being sold if there is any interest. Fran Villalba, Spanish, can play all across the midfield, basically. He's going to be the one who's playing in behind the striker right now. 24 years old, as I said, advanced playmaker. He can do it no problem whatsoever. Next up's Callum Robinson on the left-hand side. Now, we do have a bit of experience with Callum. He is a former Sheffield United man. They've only signed him this season for £350,000. And he should be good enough, I would say. Obviously, mentally and technically, he's pretty limited, but his physical should be able to carry him through at this level. And 27 years old, we'll see how he goes. 19k per week's pretty high, but he's going to have to do for now. And leading the line will be Adam Armstrong. Similar to Callum, in the case that his technical and mental attributes aren't exactly where you'd want them to be, but he's got that electric pace, which I think we could be able to take advantage of over the course of this rest of this season. And I think he will be good enough for this level. He's already scored 4 goals in 12 games in the Championship. I think I'll be able to smash that with Adam in this system, and I think he'll be able to get 20 plus goals towards the end of this season. So we do have quite a big challenge at Birmingham, I would say. Finance-wise, they're not doing absolutely brilliantly. They're still playing a loan, which should be paid until the end of 2032. Never mind. So financially, they are pretty limited. They do have some high earners on the books. 22Ks, 19Ks, 18.5, 15. Not necessarily massive money for Championship, but massive money when you're struggling and you're hemorrhaging money month over month. So it's going to have to be a situation where evaluate every time we come on, see if anybody's wanted. You can see Sonia Chia might be one of the casualties. He's one of our best players, but he's wanted by Crystal Palace currently. And if they were to give me £20 million for him, which would help us improve other areas whilst also bringing money into the club, it's got to be something we consider. But that's topics for a future episode. So for today's episode, we will be playing Bristol City at home in the league. Bristol City are currently sitting in 16th. Only 5 points ahead of us, so it is an ideal start for us, really, to hopefully be able to get our first win under our belt and start improving some of the dynamics of the club. Team cohesion-wise, they're doing absolutely fantastic, really, given the circumstances. But dressing room atmosphere is poor. Managerial support's obviously poor because I've just joined the club. So them two areas we're really, really going to have to look to improve if we want Birmingham to become a consistent, high-performing club in the Championship. Now, having said all that, let's go and look at our bars and all that. Sorry, my microphone's in the way, so I can't really see what I'm doing. But we will check Barnsley. They are currently 19th position in the Premier League. They are not doing particularly well. Currently only 4 points after 9 games. 1 win, 1 draw and 7 defeats. That is absolutely brutal. Of course, Barnsley, we finished 6th position with Barnsley. And they've had a summer to improve, and it doesn't really look like they've done the business. They've spent a lot of money, £64 million, whilst only recouping 8.75. Malik Wilkes, Dimitri Bassoli, Apple Halmir, Jamal Blackman all leaving the club. Collie Woodrun, Alex Moore ended up leaving on a free. Bruno Costas went out on loan. Marcel Tisserands went out on loan. I'm a bit surprised at that one, particularly considering he's worth £16 million. Who have they brought in then for big money? Joachim Andersen, a very, very good centre-half. An ideal signing, really. Obviously, a lot of money, but an absolutely fantastic signing. Really does improve their the defence compared to what I was playing with. Clayton signing, a goalkeeper, absolutely brilliant. It was one of the areas where I probably would have looked to improve myself if I was to stay another season with them. Aaron Moy in for £6.5 million. Not a bad player, but he's 32 years old. Christian Barrios, fantastic signing. Absolutely fantastic. Really, really good player. Fazlic was the signing we had arranged previous to leaving, £1.8 million. Nicolas Otamendi on a free. And Nicolas Castillo on loan from Spurs. Why? I honestly have no idea why Barnsley are playing as poorly as they are. They are in the Europa League as well, currently sitting third in their group. Hopefully over the course of this season they will start to find their form and find their feet without us at the helm. But I've got a sneaking suspicion Barnsley are getting relegated. So we are ready for our first game in charge of Birmingham. It will be Bristol City, the opponents at home. Let's get into the match. There has been a few changes to the first 11 compared to what I would prefer. A lot of old boys have picked up injuries, got a little knocks. So, where is he? Espinosa comes in at right back for our young English lad. Jude Bellingham comes out and McGuinn comes in that central midfielder role. He is really poor. Central midfielder will have to be an area we look to improve eventually if we can get the funds together. Bajrami comes in for Harley Dean. He's a decent enough centre-half, to be quite honest with you. It's an area of the pitch where we're not particularly struggling in terms of experienced, well-capable players. And, of course, Ray Boyd sits in goal. So we come up against them 4-1-2-3. The likes of Ben Woodburn, Manolo Gabbiadini. Decent little setup they've got, but I fancy us today. The very first highlight in charge of Birmingham City, and it's going Bristol City's way. De Silva coming down this left-hand side, whips the ball in. And Vincent Janssen gets his fourth goal of the season. We're already getting beat. Let's just pretend that didn't happen and move on with our lives. 30 minutes in now, we haven't really seen the reaction I was hoping from our boys, but we do finally get ourselves another highlight. It comes out to Sunjic on the edge of the box, plays it to Espinosa, whips a back post. Callum Robinson's there and he gets his seventh goal of the season. I believe he is our top goal scorer. And he pulls us level at 1-1. Exactly what was needed 15 minutes before half-time. Home game, our first game in charge. I would really, really like a win. It sets the ball rolling in terms of improving morale. Improving the trust in us and the dressing room atmosphere and stuff like that. Which is a severely underrated aspect of Football Manager. People don't really think about it. But when you're in that sort of bad place, the bad run, it's really the only way you can start sort of come out of it is to start improving those areas. And to get that, you need wins. Get ourselves another highlight just before half time. Can we go in 2-1 up? Callum Robinson picks up the ball on the left hand side, drives into the box. It's a poor shot in the end. And that takes us to half time. Birmingham City 1, Bristol City 1. Let's kick off for the second half and see how our boys perform. Highlight now, Espinosa with a throw in on the right hand side. Villalba to Bella. Callum Robinson's in the box again, but he can't get his head past the keeper this time. Doesn't look like the highlights over either, so we could see something else happen during this, and it is Sanabria who brings it down for Bristol City in our final third, and they go for goal and it goes just wide. With only 20 minutes or so to go, we will look to make some changes. Fran Villalba will have to come off. Who we're going to bring on, I have no idea. Alvaro Jimenez, I know he's a decent enough striker. We'll see how he performs in the attack and midfield role. Jeremy Bella can come off on the right hand side. Liam Miller can come on for him. He's pretty decent as well. We'll keep Callum Robinson on. He's having a good game. No need to take him off just yet. And with 10 minutes to go, we're going to go slightly more direct. See if we can get ourselves a goal. It wouldn't be the worst performance in the world if we are to get a draw today. But we need to hang on to that draw as Bristol City go close. Just over the bar from a free kick. 6 minutes to go. 1-1, as I've said, in our first game in charge is not too bad. The players obviously don't understand the tactic or the formation. As, Gio De Silva with an absolute... it's not even a worldie. Watch my goalkeeper when he takes this free kick. Absolutely. He moves away from it. And then he... What is that? Seriously, what was that? That was absolutely dreadful. And that is going to consign us to our first defeat in charge of Birmingham City in our first game in charge. It wasn't a bad performance from us. But results is all that matters. And we've got a lot of work to do with this Birmingham City squad. We now sit in 21st position after that defeat. Level on points with Sunderland in the relegation zone. So a lot of work to do for Birmingham City and myself. In terms of the next episode, though, it will be against Wigan and Portsmouth. That is the final games, basically, before the January transfer window, as it is the Qatar World Cup in 2022, who will take up the majority of November and December. So we'll come back then, and then obviously after that will be the January window. But anyway, if you have enjoyed today's video and you're excited for our new adventure in charge of Birmingham City, please consider leaving a like. And if you are enjoying my content, get yourself subscribed. But until next time, take it easy.